Welcome back.
I might like low-key leave the 5-second pause it was at the start.
Really?
Maybe not for audio, but for video.
Yeah. I think for audio, people would literally think like, "Is what the fuck's wrong with my fucking phone? Like, is it loading? Is the connection still trying to connect?" Tell us if you hear that, by the way.
Is there a fucking monsoon outside?
Oh my goodness. The Hurricane Katrina outside. You got a trampoline with its own mind. Shit's just gone wrong, boys. Anyway, welcome back to the PNC Lads podcast. Episode, I want to say it's episode 133.
It's like 137.
Fuck. Fuck's sakes. Ah, just could be seven.
Well, like 136 like or something. It's late.
Yeah. It's far from ideal. But we're back. And we're tired, boys, once again, because if you tuned into the last episode, we said that was a debrief episode of New Year's Eve. And we said that this is going to be a debrief episode, as well as a few other things from Wildlands Festival. Because boy, oh boy, it was a highly anticipated event for us, really.
Yeah, I was just saying to you, I'm excited. I'm happy that it's over.
Mm.
Age is really catching up, but also, bro, the start of this year, it's what, the 9th? Is it the 9th today?
It's the 8th today.
Fuck me. I tell you what, 8 days of shit. I haven't done a single good thing for my body since fucking New Year.
It's before New Year. Evan, help me.
Dude, my body is literally like, I've had enough.
When was the last time you ate some fruit?
Oh, bro, I'm not kidding.
Could you actually tell me though, when was the last time you ate some fruit?
It would have been last year, probably.
In December?
Some like watermelon. Yeah, it would have been like watermelon or something.
Okay, sweet.
Like rock melon or something like that. But dude, I've barely put anything good in my body.
Mm.
I was on a pretty good routine up until New Year's Eve. I was eating my fucking chicken and rice. I was having some pasta.
Some pasta. Yeah, it's unfortunate that... I mean, this is life though, isn't it?
January has always, my entire life, been a bit like, I mean, not when I was under 18, a bender. But ever since then, like, January's always cooked. It's Australia Day, birthdays, fucking festivals. It's New Year's Eve.
We've got, like, 7 people having their birthdays in the last 10 days of January.
Yeah.
Our family, extended family.
Same as mine. It's just January. It's everyone be fucking in October, bro. Like,
yeah.
Is that? No, not October. When do they fucking?
9 months.
April.
Something like that.
Easter. Everyone's fucking on Easter, bro.
That chocolate got them bitches horny.
Yeah.
And by bitches, I mean men and women. Because I actually low-key can't wait for that Easter chocolate, bro. I mean, I usually tell my mum and dad, don't bother.
I
always get something.
I'm not a big fan of, like, the bunny chocolates.
We weren't here for Easter last year.
No, we weren't.
We were in Victoria.
Mm.
It's a little bit cray-cray.
It's almost been a year since we went to Victoria, bro.
That's
true. It's been 11 months.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That is true. Yeah, because I graduated.
We went on that the 9th of Feb.
Fuck, that's weird. Yeah. That is really weird.
It's very scary how quick time goes. But, I mean, you know, we're run down, but it's done now until Bali. Done. So we've got 3 weeks till Bali, 3 weeks to be on top of my shit.
Can sort of detox and really look after the body. Mm. Give it the nurturing that it requires and needs.
Yeah. I've already decided that the birthday is on a Saturday, which is mildly inconvenient in terms of trying to be healthy, but
oddly inconvenient things.
We'll go for a pub feed and have a pint of fucking CC and dry on tap and call it a night. Maybe we'll come back, watch the fucking soccer or something down here and
that is back, pup. That is the only beverage I can actually just sit and enjoy.
Yeah, it's a very enjoyable beverage, particularly on tap.
If you give me that any day all year round on tap, I will say thank you very much. That was beautiful.
See that, ladies? That's all you got to do. Like, if you ever go on a date with Dill, just go to the bathroom, buy him a CC and a pint on tap. And
it's hard to come by, though.
Yeah. They are.
Some people say, what?
I know.
Some people say, CC and dry. Mm. Oh, no, I'm not a fan. And then they've never actually fucking tried it.
Yeah. It's absurd to me. Because it's like twice as good as a can, I feel like.
You know what I don't like, though? And then what I'm not a fan of? I actually got it gifted to me for Christmas. But CC and dry, not pre-mixed in a bottle.
Nah, you just got to make it right. Because I've played with it before. You can make a pretty good brew because you can make it like weaker, if you will.
The thing is these days, I'm like ultra health conscious. And like when someone gives me alcohol, I tend to think, do you know me?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's valid. It's just a cop-out. Like, it's an easy one to do.
Yeah. I'm always like, I don't drink.
But in saying that, if like you get a nice Grey Goose bottle, bro.
If I get vodka, different story.
It's handy because you know you'll use it.
That will get used. However, I'm almost never going to open that bottle of like CC and Dry, that bottle of Jack Daniels.
Yeah.
Because like I'm just never going to take that to a prez and drink it.
100%.
And then I'm never going to just enjoy that at home because I don't enjoy drinking that like in that way. I drink because I have to.
Yeah, it's a little bit.
I don't drink for pleasure, bro. I drink because I have to in situations.
It's sad, as sad as that is, it's kind of reality. But we should dive in because it's been a week. I feel like last week post New Year was the same as the week between Christmas and fucking New Year. Like it just, you could before say I knew it, it was Saturday.
You could say that and I'd agree.
But once again, this time not as many people as I
It was the same as New Year's Eve and I actually thought it was going to be a lot bigger like spilt milk. However, I think we should, I don't know if you've seen this show, it's called Death Note, and this bloke writes names in a book and it kills these people. And I think these people kind of just deserve it.
What the fuck are you talking about, buddy?
Andrew Corrigan, Snakes.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Pathetic.
Frank Matawa, Snake.
Pathetic.
Dil Sakamoto, Jamo Lennon. Can understand you enough.
Yeah, that's fair enough. They weren't in the country. Oh, in Perth, WA.
Zach Denholm, one of our besties.
Yeah, that was Slytherin. He was Slytherin.
But... boy, oh boy,
Snake. It's not good because that was a deal. There was a handshake agreement made.
You lose a bet. You place a bet. You state the odds. You shake your hand and you lose the bet and you don't follow through.
You've got to honor that bet.
Snake. Who else? Who else was in there?
I think that's everyone.
I think that's everyone. Yeah, we don't have many friends.
No, it's funny. I was saying this to someone the other day. I was actually saying like the difference between 21 and like 23 is insane. And 21 year olds would be like, shut up. But it's so true.
It is.
But like, because in your 21st year, you still are hanging out with all the schoolmates. You're hanging out with everyone from school, even if you're not even like that close with them. It's just the 21st, everyone from school goes still. After the 21st is done, it is done. I don't see anyone from school bar the 9 guys plus me in the group chat.
Yeah, the year of the 21st is a fucked one. It's a really fucked one. I remember thinking like, I mean, you don't take it for granted because you got invited to everyone's 21st.
Yeah,
and it's like, bro, I barely even know you, man.
Yeah.
But like, oh, you'd message the group chat and we had an extended group chat at times with like fucking 20 people and you'd be like, who's going? Oh, if 50% are going, you're probably going to fucking go.
Yeah.
And it was almost 50% are going.
Yeah.
It was alcos back then, bro.
Yeah, but it's just like now we just have like such a close, small group of friends. They were a little fucking snaky on this weekend, but I'll let it slide. I'll let it slide.
They'll have a chance to redeem themselves this month.
Yeah. But it's all right. We move on. We kick the in fairness, Prez was still good because your cousin and his mate came and then...
M&M.
So we had 6, which 6 is actually a very good number for Ubers.
Yeah,
because we only had to get one Uber. It was like a $78 Uber, but, you know, for a 20-minute ride, but, you know, you fucking cop that.
Worked out perfectly. I mean, Prez was, it was great fun again. Rocked up and we hadn't eaten. So we get there, Joe and I get there, Jimbo dropped us off. And you mentioned pizzas and I said, fucking get me in that because I didn't even start drinking, bro, because I knew, bro, I have one drink. It literally go to my head, bro.
Yeah.
Especially because I'd worked out and not consumed anything.
Yeah. Disaster. If we didn't eat those pizzas, I think I'd be in a lot worse state.
For sure. Oh, yeah. Big time. Big time. And then Rambo was lucky. I mean, we left.
We had to stop ourselves from eating it, the whole thing.
Yeah, we did. Otherwise, we would have yacked. Rambo rocks up. He brings the goods in terms of alcohol, mixes. He's great for that. And then really, we just get down to it. We start playing games. We start drinking. I mean, this room, boys and girls, I don't know what this room does, but it's just got an aura about it, I reckon.
It's very... Bro,
It's like a little dungeon.
Because it's inside, dude. Inside pre's is always better than outside in Australia in summer, unless you have a pool. But like,
it's because there's many factors that you can control.
You're air conditioned. You're not getting fucked by the sun. There's no wind. So it's pristine conditions for pong, card games.
Also, there's two stories separating us from anyone else.
Yeah.
At yep. most times.
No one comes down here to bug you.
No.
There's a toilet there. It's fucking great.
A toilet, a pisser right there. You've got easy access to outside if you need to urinate or get a nice little trick of snappy, chappy, wappy.
Yep.
Ed's got his decks up there. 80-inch fucking TVs. I know it's 70, but I want to say 80.
Yeah.
And like you said, fucking reverse cycle ting, making sure I'm cool, calm, and collected because I get nervous when I get sweaty.
Yeah. Pre-festival, which we'll get into because it was fucking hot on Saturday.
The anxiety rises when I start to heat up internally and I'm not good at calming myself down. So that's tough, but
yep.
I don't know what it is about this room. It's fantastic. We've definitely christened it by now.
I had a lot of people reply to my story saying like, fuck, that's elite. Because I posted the room.
Oh, yeah.
My story.
Yeah, with the lights.
But no, it's going to be good come footy season. I feel like having that TV on the wall, just having a nice couple of Bev tings down here.
Yep.
And it's close, but we fucking harped on this last week, so you're all like, you kind of get this, you get the gist. But we then went to the festival. We got there at like 3, pretty much, about 3 o'clock, just in time for good old Blanky, Blank. But it was fucking hot. It was warm. Like for anyone who was in Perth and knows, it was hot. It was like 34 degrees, and we were in Claremont, which had it was like you're kind of surrounded by a bit of a building in the middle, so there's not really any airflow. It was scorching. It was warm.
And if anyone knows Claremont Showgrounds, I don't know how it compares to other venues across Australia where Wildlands was held, but it's an absolute fucking journey and a half to get to different stages.
Yeah, I know. All these fucking places keep wanting to do it at Claremont Showgrounds as well. Feel like there's not too many venues that can have 3 stages, which is potentially why.
Yeah.
But it is, in my opinion, it is not a great facility for a festival, just based off how spread out everything is. But not just that, to get to the other stages, you got to do like a big loop. You can't just like cut through. They like fucking fenced it off. So we had to do a whole big arc around to try and get, it's like a fucking K and a half walk.
Mm. And did you would you say you prefer Joondalup, where Listener is usually held?
Yeah, Joondalup's way better. HBF Arena is way better.
Yeah, it's just except for the reception. Guaranteed no reception there.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's unfortunate as well. When we rocked up, the stage that we wanted to get to for literally like the first 3-4 acts was in Timbuk fucking 2.
Yeah, it was all, that's what I'm saying. It was like a K and a half around the fucking other side.
Not protected by any shade, as no festivals are, but like 36 in Perth with high humidity. It's fucking hot.
It was warm. Like,
it's fucking hot.
And we had to put sunscreen on at the Red Frogs.
We did go to the Red Frogs, put some sunscreen on. I'm glad the morning of, I downed a Powerade Zero Sugar and I actually drank some water whilst I got here as well, because I just knew, bro.
Yeah.
I just knew I had to be hydrated that day. And it still wasn't enough.
Yeah, I was very dehydrated when I got
it. Still wasn't enough. I think we're all a bit, little bit pink in the face as well in certain areas. Sunscreen. I mean, bro, we saw a clip of a girl on TikTok who got the most disgusting blisters from a sunburn at BTV in Victoria.
Yeah.
Obviously, you can get severe sunburn like when it's cloudy and overcast, but what the fuck?
22 bro? And overcast.
She must be so prone to it, bro.
Yeah, I mean, even just if you just, I mean, it is like a 5-day festival. So if you didn't put sunscreen on for 5 days and just went in the sun for 10, 12 hours, like you'd get cooked. But if you did that in Perth for fucking 5 days, I don't know. I don't actually think if they had Beyond the Valley in Perth for the same, like over that same weekend, I don't know if it would actually be feasible, or a lot more people would be like in a lot worse states.
Yeah.
Because 22 to 26 degrees for the whole weekend, for the whole 4 days or whatever the festival goes for, overcast, it's not that hot, let's be honest.
Yeah.
Compared to here, where the lowest is probably like 30, 2 maybe, and it's fucking, there's no clouds, it's just blistering sun on you for 4 days.
Yeah.
People would be dehydrated, fucking cooked, which, not saying they didn't even be on the valley, but if it was here, escalate that shit way worse.
Yeah. You know what I've actually been thinking of, just to little like break up the chat for a second? New Year's Eve next year, I'm just highly considering wanting to go down south for it. Because I spoke to a lot of people who did that, and there's multiple things on, but I don't know if you've been before, but it's called Caves House, and it's like this, like...
Caves.
Massive fucking place that's like a big pub. So many people get rowdy there, they drink, they eat.
I had a few people that went there and they still said it was mid.
Well, I've heard otherwise from some people, so I suppose it depends on who you ask. But just to just change it up from the shitty events that are on.
I tell you what, we should just get an Airbnb with 10 below, or I mean, a lot of guys have got misses, which makes it a little more difficult, I guess, but like if we could just get a house, just like this house here, and we can just like chill in like this room with the 10 boys, fucking, we don't have to, I don't even really care for going out. I mean, there could be a sick event next year, never know, doubt it, but
we do never know. But let's quickly go over all the different acts that we saw. So you said we saw Blank.
Yeah, he was actually really good. It was just so hot.
And also like for me, it was nowhere near as fucked up as I needed to be.
Yeah.
To see him. So I was kind of forcing myself to try and enjoy it.
It was hot, bro. I just remember I was just fucking like, holy shit, I need a drink. We got a Red Bull vodka, I'd come back and it'd be gone in like 30 seconds because I was so just thirsty from the heat.
Yeah.
And then like then there was fucking, who was after Blank? I think it was Anna Lundy, maybe. No, there was one before her, maybe.
I'm just getting it up. So Stum was before Blank, and then
yeah, it was Anna Lundy.
How do you say it?
I don't know.
Anna Luno,
yeah.
Yeah.
She was pretty good actually, but once again,
oh, she was hot. She was
so hot, yeah. Woman,
yeah.
But it was fucking, once again, the weather was hot.
Yeah.
Like 4:30, right? It was just stinking, dude. I'm thinking, we need to go to the bar again.
Good looking woman who put on a great show. And all this time, we're trying to find our boy Frank, who's just, once again, he was a snake for not coming to the prees with us, but he said that he committed to another prees months ago that he forgot about. Convenient, yeah. I say.
But also, it was like, because of how the festival was set up, so hard to find people.
Yeah.
Like, we didn't even know how to get to the stage that we were at.
And then we're telling him to
try. And then we're like, you try and find it. And like, he was probably more fucked up than us at that point.
Yeah.
And it's like, because I was just asking people. I was asking every secchi, where's stage 3? Even they didn't know.
Yeah.
I think it's over that way.
Yeah.
He literally pointed the wrong way. Yeah. I was like, are you an idiot?
No, it's insanely poor for the staff and security not to know. Like, what happens, bro? Hey, there's someone with a knife fucking stabbing people on stage 3. Where's that?
He runs the wrong way, bro.
How do you not know? If, bro, you're literally there for if shit goes down, how do you not know the layout of the event?
Yeah, I was pretty like, dude, I think it might have even been you. You were like, didn't he point that way? And I was like, yeah, but I don't think he knows what the fuck he's talking about, mate.
I can't even remember.
Like, I just remember someone asking me, because
I asked someone.
It might have been
early,
Tom, actually. Because I was like, oh, which way is stage 3? And he was like, he pointed right. And then I was like, okay, you don't know what you're talking about. And then I was like, let's just go this way. And then Tom was like, didn't he point that way? I was like, yeah, but that bloke fucking doesn't know his left and rights, mate, because that guy's literally dumbass.
The stages, I don't even think, had the names of them.
Oh, they did
them as well, which is crazy to me.
Yeah. It was a good festival in terms of the acts, the setup, bit mid, and then also I feel like, I mean, I thought I was sort of maybe just tripping a little bit, but the crowd was fucking aggressive as, like, and then I saw a lot of TikTok comments saying the same thing, so I was like, fuck, I wasn't tripping.
You know,
but, oh my God.
I said that to my dad. And he was like, apparently the use of ketamine is on the rise. Apparently that's
I mean, it's, yeah, it's in Melbourne. Ketamine's huge.
A little bit angry.
I just also think that had way more people than Spilt Milk did.
Oh, fuck
yeah. I think there was 30,000 there, potentially.
Well, all right, bro. I mean, we'll get into the last act later. But after that, we saw Lude.
Very good. But once again, very hot.
Good. Also can't really remember too much of it.
I don't really remember any of the last three acts, if I'm being completely honest, but yeah. All I remember, if I don't remember, it must have been good. That's how I would say it.
Subfocus, quite the same, right after Lude. And then I remember everyone is leaving Subfocus to go see Rufus. And holy fuck. I mean, it's a journey there, firstly. But we get there, and bro, it's sort of like, it's like over the hedge, bro. I just couldn't believe my eyes. It was the fattest sea of people.
If you have time, just go on TikTok and type in Wildlands Rufus Perth. And there's videos of like the whole oval was just full. I think that was 30,000 for him.
Yeah. Tom literally said he didn't go to Tomorrowland when he went to Europe. But he went to Ultra and he said, this is literally bigger than any crowd I saw in Europe. Which is just like crazy.
That was big.
I mean, because it was, I showed my daddy, he was like, oh fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Like that is big.
We were pretty close in grand scheme of,
I mean, yeah, we,
how many people there were.
Musty and Maya, we'll call them. They didn't want to go. One of them was feeling a little bit average. So we said, I'm not waiting. Like, I wanted to see them. We're going in. And actually we were able to like just trail the outskirts and eventually just work our way in.
Yeah.
Which was surprising. And I remember I got on your shoulders and I was just like, I was on there for like a good one or two songs and they were the bangers as well. Mm. And I was like, oh yeah.
Everyone was just,
oh yeah.
Everyone was just mad aggressive to me, bro. Like, cause I was always the one like leading through the packs and shit. So naturally, rave etiquette is like, if someone's trying to get past, you just let them go through. And if you're one of those, I'm fucking cool you out right now. If you're one of those piece of shit fucking losers who is like trying to stand in front of someone who's trying to walk past you because you don't want them to get in front of you, go and fucking fuck your nan, you fucking piece of shit. You literally suck as a human. Rave etiquette, do not go to a rave if you do not know basic rave etiquette. If someone's on the ground passed out, you help them up. You don't fucking trample on them. If someone's passed out, you find them water. If someone's trying to get past you, you let them go past and you say, stay safe, mate. It's fucking rave etiquette, bro. There was none of that at Wildlands. Not a cracker.
Bro, we were getting drinks one time and you like ran off and like knocked my elbow a little bit, dropped my drink and it spilled on the floor and then a bit of it got in this guy's shoes who was walking past. He's like, oh, for fuck's sake. And I'm like, sorry, mate. Like literally just got knocked out of my hand. I was like, I'm pissed off right now. Just had a fucking $16 drink knocked out of my hand. And he's like, I think you fucking owe me a drink. And I was like, I owe you a drink for dropping mine and a bit of it spraying you. I said, not a fucking chance, buddy. Off you go.
Yeah.
And he was like, oh, fuck off, man. I'm like, fuck off, champ.
Dude, the amount of time. Like, dude, Jesus I was at the bar getting water for everyone. I was just getting six cups. And I think someone, I don't know who was with me. One of the boys was like just to my right because I was giving them the cups.
It was me.
And the guy at the bar next to me, he's waiting to get actual drinks. And I'm obviously getting water, so I just like cut the line to get water and I'm just like filling up cups of water and he's just like fucking pushing in, mate. And I was just like, buddy, I'm literally getting water, mate. And he was like, yeah, fucking wait in the line. And I said, you're literally getting drinks, buddy. I'm getting water for these blokes. And then I started mouthing off and I was like, you're not gonna do fucking shit, bro. There's literally a secchi next to me. And he's kind of like laughing at the situation.
Yeah.
And then I'm just like looking at the secchi and he's just like, don't even worry about this fucking idiot. I was just like, dude, what is your problem? You're literally getting a proper drink. I'm getting water from a fucking water dispenser.
Yeah.
But
there was plenty of them. And also, once we got this water, bro, after a minute and a half passing, the whole cup was flooded with shit.
Yeah. Well, it's funny. That guy, as I like was about to leave, I was filling up my last cup and he was still chirping and I was like, buddy, you're 4 foot fucking two, buddy. You're going to do nothing. And then he was just like choked up and didn't know what like to say back as I walked off. It was kind of funny. But I was like, yeah, you're literally 4 foot two, mate. Like, come on.
Yeah,
small man syndrome, bro.
You get those aggro people at the festival.
Dude, so unnecessary.
But places like this, bro, the water was just filthy. It was disgusting. Just shit mongled in there. And then also, by the end of the night, I told my dad this. You go to blow your nose because it's just so fucked with shit, bro. And oh my God, it is just black gunk.
Yeah, it's coming just out. Dirt, bro, yeah.
And I'm like, what is going on? It is the most vile shit ever.
Yeah.
I'm like, I hope this isn't just me. Nah, because if anyone saw this, oh my God, they would be just disgusted.
Everyone was just like defeated too. I remember because you guys left straight after Rufus or a little bit thing. We just like went into the silent disco for like 10 minutes.
Where was that? How far away was the silent disco?
Nah, it was like close. And then we just, we're like, oh, well, let's go find these party buses, which I thought they had free party buses back to the city, but there was none. Mm. So we ended up just getting the train. And then once we got on the train, we were dead. But we were just like, it felt like 4 a.m. Mm. on the train. And it was like 10:45, 11.
To be fair, bro, like, I mean, we started early.
Yeah, we did start early, but I think the sun just destroyed us
Of course, but that doesn't help. Like, I woke up. We were playing Fortnite the night before. What a throwback, by the way, saying that.
Yeah.
Playing Fortnite the night before. We got off at like 11. I woke up at 7:30 to go to the gym. Had one meal in me the whole day, which was a pizza, not even finished, three pieces remaining. I mean, yeah, I had that with heavy sun exposure, a lot of alcohol. Fuck, no wonder you just want to go home by the end of it, bro.
Once I sat on the train for like 10 minutes in, I was like, yep,
get me home.
Get me home. Yeah. I got home at 11:30 and dude, I was actually okay. I dozed off for about half an hour. Woke up.
In your clothes? Like you didn't have
I was just laying on my bed. I woke up and I was like, oh, I'm going to go have a shower. I had a shower, went back in, laid in bed for like 40 minutes, trying to just drink water. Then after drinking like probably a liter of water, I was like, oh, fuck, I'm starting to feel dusty now.
Oh, no.
Ran back to the shower. I'm on all fours, bro.
Oh, no.
In the shower, like this, sitting on the ground. And I'm just like, I felt like my tummy was like sore, but I didn't even put my fingers down my throat. I just was like, I started dry reaching deliberately. Like I was
just try and get yourself going.
And then I just started yakking. And it was just this green, dirty, black shit as well. Like from the dirt, like your nose looks like,
yeah.
But like a little bit of fucking alcohol, food and shit. I yak, I go back up to my room. I'm not going to go to bed yet. Keep drinking water. Yeah. Went and got, about an hour goes past, went and got some Weet-Bix. Cause I was like, I need to get some like carbs in like quick.
Yeah.
So I go grab Weet-Bix.
Bro, those three pieces of pizza would have came in handy, bro. Yeah, where were they?
Bro, Rambo ate them, but I.
Yeah, your three as well.
Yeah, I said he could have them all. Oh, but I grabbed Weet-Bix. I took one bite.
Yeah.
Of the Weet-Bix. As soon as I had the one bite, I was like.
It's rolling up.
Oh, my tummy feels. Ran back down to the shower. Same thing on all fours again. And I'm just yakking, bro. And I'm like, fuck, trying to drink more water. I probably drank 2 liters of water in like 3 hours. I ended up going to bed about 3:30, 4 in the morning. I got home at 11:30. So for 4 hours, I was just yakking, drinking water, watching TV in a ball. And then when I woke up, I actually felt fine.
Bro, so that was your night. That was your night, right? We got back to Tom's house. Thankfully got picked up by my cousin Gabby. And got back. Hydrolite. I took 2 Panadol. I then had like a Biscoff cinnamon donut, like finger scroll type of thing.
A cinnamon scroll? Because I love those.
It was so weird, bro. And I dipped it in like the melted Biscoff. Had that. Then I went for a shower. And then it was just like us 4 guys. We chucked on like Outer Banks. Watched an episode of that. And I was like, fine, hey. Yeah. I wasn't hurting at all. I was nowhere near throwing up. I didn't feel like throwing up. I literally felt fine. Go for a shower. That freshened me up a lot. And I was knackered. I went to bed around like 12:31. And then I woke up and I was fine again, hey.
The next day when I woke up, I felt fine. Because I went to bed at 4, woke up at like 8:30.
Yeah.
And I felt like I didn't feel like sick. I just felt tired.
Yeah.
So I naturally slept like half the day in and out of naps.
What, the next day?
Yeah, I didn't leave bed.
Well, thankfully, I mean, all 4 of us were in the same mindset. And thankfully, my auntie was nice enough to drive us to the beach. As soon as we got in the ocean water, bro, I was like, this is how you get over hangover. You could literally feel bottom of the barrel shit.
Salt water, bro. Does things to you.
You could literally feel bottom of the barrel shit. Like, worst hangover ever. If you get in that ocean water and it's like a little bit cold, Thankfully, it was sunny that day. The sea breeze wasn't in. And we just, oh man, it just was fantastic. We body surfed a bit. And I just felt so much better, bro. Just felt so much better.
I was just glad that I yacked that night. Like, I was actually so thankful for the miserable, like, 4 hours I had when I got home. I actually think majority of it was low-key sunstroke.
Well, yeah, that's the thing, because like, I feel like we didn't... I felt like we sweat that much, the alcohol... I don't know. I mean, obviously dehydration.
The problem with that is when you're drinking and you sweat, you're sweating out the water.
Fluids, yeah.
Whereas, and then you're just left with alcohol, and that's why you get such a brutal hangover. But that's why I like stayed up, because I was like, I just need to keep drinking water. Because bro, when I got home, my piss was fucking brown. Like the first piss I had at 11 was brown. And then by about 3, I was pissing every fucking 20 minutes because I had drank so much water. Like I drank a literal liter refillable from the fridge and then 2 600 ml cups.
That's like, a lot.
It was a lot of water, but
bro, it saved me. You gotta get hydrolyte on standby, bro.
We have some somewhere. I was so fucked up though.
Yeah. Like, if I'm going back to my house, make sure there's Powerade Zero waiting for me, or like hydrolyte. It literally just saves your life, boys and girls. If you just need to drop 2 tablets in some water and just fucking guzz it. I didn't even eat. I barely ate anything. That's the thing. Yeah, and I just felt all right. Thank you.
But yeah, that was the hangover from Wildlands. It was not the most fucking pleasant experience, but...
Let us know how you found Wildlands, because I know a lot of people went.
Let me know if you guys had the same aggressive crowd experience. I feel like, I mean, even we didn't get... Like, we didn't get any fights, but like...
Even in the different states as well, let us know how you found it.
The fights were more of a good Samaritan from us as opposed to the other people, because, I mean, if yous know us, I mean, I'd rather... not fight by like ever, because the prime time fucking McGregor will kick me in the chin or something and I'll die. So I'd rather just fucking just be like, just get out of here, son.
Yeah, well, so you get yourself a fucking criminal charge or something, you get locked up
for no reason. So, you know, usually diffuse and walk away. But I just couldn't imagine the amount of people that would just drop a shoulder into me as I'm walking past, or like stand in front of me, or like push me back, put an arm in. I'm like, what the fuck?
Wasn't great, but what would you rate it out of 10? Festival?
I don't really remember much, from being honest, but I would say, I would give it like an 8 maybe. I had a good time.
I'd give it like a 7.3. Just because, unfortunately, external factors do play a part.
It was really hot.
That's the thing.
That was a big factor, like,
so, but I still had a good time. Glad I went. But I say we do move on.
I'm very glad that festivals are done.
Yeah.
Festivals, to say that. Like, I'm very excited to finally get into my gym. I haven't even had a proper fucking gym program structure at all. Like, I've just been missing a day here and there, training legs, just because I'm like, I got a plan for the festival, I want sore legs. Like, it's been all over the shop. So I'm excited to have fucking structure.
Routine really makes sure the mental takes care of itself, really.
Yeah.
Routine is everything.
Like I said, let us know how your Wildlands experience was, or your other festival experiences, Beyond the Valley, whatever you guys went to over New Year. I heard there's been a crippling bug run through Beyond the Valley.
Ooh.
A lot of people on TikTok are just like, who the fuck brought
gonorrhea
to, something like that, like to the fucking thing, and like, I haven't got out of bed for 4 days and shit.
Yeah.
I think it was glandular fever, not gonorrhea.
Well, I've had that.
Yeah, it's not
good. You know that, like, it can literally stay in your system for ages. Yeah. Just comes and goes, bro. It's not fun. Anyway, the old aliens in Miami story going on.
Yeah.
Bro, rock up. Oh, I go on Twitter and I just see this video of like someone in a hotel, and it's...
Oh, wasn't it in a shopping mall?
Well, no, yeah, but the camera's pointed down because they're so high up, and there's literally hundreds of cop cars on the road flaring their fucking sirens. And I don't know what they're there for. Apparently, there was a fight between kids.
There was more than that. Like, kids... So, the actual story that they released was that it was a... like a bunch of like teenage kids were just like throwing shit through shopping, like stores, like fighting people, like just pretty much public nuisance. But to shut down an entire shopping mall for that,
I saw people,
it's pretty wild.
I saw people running, bro. I saw people running as well. And like, I saw like grown men running, bro. Like people in their 20s running. Like, And that many cars for that situation?
Yeah, for kids causing a ruckus is a little extreme. Like, if you like, I always see people fucking being dickheads at like carousel and shit, and all that, like, nothing happens. Like, no. Maybe 10 police officers will come and arrest them. But to shut down a whole shopping mall in Miami, I don't know. Maybe something for, I don't know if it's aliens or if fucking whatever.
Don't know what it is, and we probably just won't find out for whatever reason, but it was just so, I was like, this can't be for this reason.
Bro. What gets me with that sort of shit is that the realistic possibility that alien, like, I'm a big believer that there's some alien form life out there, whether we're ever going to see them or not, whether they're on Earth or not, I don't know. But the possibility that aliens are how humans have thought they would look like forever is probably next to zero. Like, the realistic odds that an alien has a head that's shaped in like a love heart fucking style with two eyes and antennas with fucking six fingers and five toes or four toes, probably not the case. Like, if there's genuinely aliens and they're so intelligent to have got on Earth, they're going to look like you or I. Let's be realistic. Like, I don't know.
Yeah, so, I mean, I've just been watching the new Life on Our Planet, and they've been going through day fucking one of Earth, like literally billions of years ago. And they explain how new stuff just kind of became what it is. Mm. And it really makes you think like, fuck.
Oh, it's cool as fuck, dude. I love listening to Rogan when he has like archaeologists and shit on.
Yeah.
So fucking.
It's like, it really makes you think like, fuck, there is just so much more out there.
Oh yeah.
I mean, like, and out of this universe, out of this galaxy, like there could just be another fucking version of this.
That's the thing. Like, we can see trillions of years away, like light years, which means it would take trillions of light years to get there, which no human can live that long. But if there's alien form on Earth, like, for us to have not known it or ever have been seen by like the public, then they have to be so smart that they're not going to get caught in a fucking Miami shopping mall. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, but then also the way that they were described as were like gray,
like a transparent.
Yeah. And type of thing. I'm like, you know, like, is that real? I mean, I like to think, I prefer to believe that shit like that's real because it's more entertaining, but I don't know.
It's just a really interesting story. When I woke up, so I was like, oh.
Yeah, I was like, that's fucking hilarious.
We got aliens before GTA 6.
Yeah, I know, bro. Fuck, GTA 6, dude. Give me that game.
Next on this one, I want to talk about just real quickly. Like, can I touch you, hairdresser?
Oh, dude. Fuck, I don't have the video on it here that we can play. But for everyone who doesn't know the hairdresser video where it's like that trans community where they're just like, she's like, oh, what pronouns do you go by? She's like, she, they, or fucking they, them, whatever, blah, blah, blah. She's like, oh my God, me too. She's like, is it okay if I touch you now? And she's like, yep, you have my consent. And she's like, I'm glad we've got that out the way. Now let's get the cut underway. The fuck you get, you come on.
How the fuck are you going to cut someone's hair?
Yeah, this is the funniest example I saw in the comments. I'd love for one of these people to have a fucking heart attack and be in hospital.
Can I touch you?
And then, the nurse. Do you mind if we just cut you open? She's like,
sorry, I'm gonna need a clear yes.
Honey, if you can't consent, I need you to give me a thumbs up. She's like, having a fucking fit, bro. Like, dude, what the fuck are we doing? If you go to the fucking hairdresser, you know what you gotta, someone's touching your head.
Imagine she gets resuscitated and then after she's in recovery and she goes, who was that fucking person that fucking saved my life? How fucking dare you?
Who
did you get my consent?
Who took my fucking top off and saw my tits? Like, shut up.
Just outrageous.
Man.
John, what's his name? The one that we met in Victoria.
Bernard.
John Bernard. He was like one of the first to like do one of those funny skits. I've seen a couple more that have hopped on it. Fucking hilarious, bro.
So good.
Just like the ethnics and the wog barbers who are like, I don't give a fuck, bro. Yeah. Cut my fucking hair. How else are you going to do it? It's just so fucking funny, man. And like, bro, you know, this is how angry it gets me. I literally blocked that barber because before all the shit went viral, I saw a couple of her TikToks.
Oh,
and
really?
I was like, this is pissing me off.
Dude,
I got so triggered. I blocked her. So I didn't want to see any more of her shit.
Surely, consent comes with getting in that chair, right?
Rocking up to go get a haircut, you think you automatically say, yeah, go for it, touch me hair.
But it's just ridiculous. I mean,
it is.
Like,
it's just laughable. I mean, I think you just see the shift and we just don't need to be that absurd. It's not inclusive. It's just being fucking absurd.
It is flipping. I mean, 4 years ago, that was way more prominent. Now you've got like this fucking almost anti it where it's like everyone's standing up for what's actually right.
Yeah.
Like 99% of the population is like, you guys are fuckwits. 4 years ago, everyone would just be quiet about it because they were scared. But now like the voice of the... I feel like celebrities are starting to kind of shit on it more.
Yeah.
Without getting cancelled. And I actually think Tate low-key inspired that a bit more. Because, well, he kind of has shown that like you can say whatever you want and it's actually impossible to get cancelled unless you accept the cancel.
Mm.
Like you can say whatever you want and people can try and cancel you, but the reality, unless you get deleted off the platforms,
yeah,
which is, you'd have to be fucking pretty drastic for that.
Well, fucking, unless you Steve will do it, poor guy.
Yeah, well, I mean, but even still, like, I wouldn't, like, he's still making crazy money.
Yeah, they sometimes pick and choose, unfortunately.
Yeah, I mean, it is what it is. But yeah, I think it's starting to go the other way. I mean, you can see with just how much memes and stuff of those vids get promoted now.
Yeah.
And a lot of businesses and brands are starting to regress on their wokeness because they're losing record profits. Disney's lost $100 million last year because they're trying to be woke. Fucking Bud Light or whatever that beer was lost like 70% of their stock value.
Yeah, I saw a girl going over like Star Wars and the new director's POV of it and she's like, this is fucking stupid.
Yeah, imagine, I saw a guy actually explaining that because the director of it said, I love making men uncomfortable.
And
this guy was like, imagine your core fan base being men. Why the fuck would they pay to be uncomfortable?
And also, and this woman,
great marketing,
was going over it and she was like, how fucking thick you, and we want to create strong women leads. Princess Leia, fucking bat, like just absolute G. You had the one that fucking
idolized characters, bro.
You had the one that Padme.
Everyone wanted to fuck her, yeah.
Like literally a fucking baddie, bro. Like with Anakin, like you just all so many different roles.
Bro, Princess fucking Leia is like at the core of Star Wars. That's like the base storyline almost literally evolves around her.
Mm.
Anakin, like obviously Anakin and like the Skywalker family, but like the core of it is like Princess Leia and fucking what's the geezer that drives the spaceship?
Han Solo. Yeah.
He rescues her. I remember playing the Star Wars games. That was like half the missions.
Yeah, well, I know the new girl who was playing Sleeping Beauty, she was getting fucking fired on because she was like, yeah, there's not going to be any fucking Knight and Charming prince saving me in the movie because it's 2023 and we don't need fucking men, blah, 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 blah. And she was getting destroyed.
Yeah.
Literally destroyed. So if that movie's even still coming out, it's going to be bad, bro. Like, it's not going
to
get
good. Imagine you being the director of a big movie for yourself, like one of the biggest franchises ever to exist, Star Wars, and you've gone and decided to go as your marketing campaign. Let's say to our core audience that we love making you feel uncomfortable and this movie's going to make you feel uncomfortable. Who in their right mind would do that?
George Lucas, the OG, probably be throwing up in his grave.
Oh, he'd be throwing a tantrum. I wouldn't blame him.
Wouldn't blame him either.
Bro, there was women idolized figures in Star Wars. I mean, we could go on about this all day, but it's just ridiculous.
You haven't seen Star Wars, the OG ones. Go do yourself a favor, boys.
It's good stuff.
Anyway, let's do the Spotify playlist before we piece the scene. My first one, Vultures, Kanye's new single.
I haven't heard it.
Kind of nice. You can kind of, vibe to it, bro.
Nice. I like that. I like it a lot, man.
And then I'm here, so I'm going to have my next one. Nightcrawler by Travis Scott, Sway Lee, Chief Keef.
I like it.
You got some good things in there.
I'm going to go with Where the Wild Things Are by Luke Combs.
Where the Wild Things Are.
And
shout out Luke. I know he's a big fan of the fucking podcast.
Yeah. Have we got Nicky Hendrix in there with Future and Nicki Minaj?
Nicky Hendrix, is that a song?
Yeah.
I'm going to try and add it. Actually, it'll tell me if it's in there. Oh my god, bro. Add to playlist. It's not in there. You want it in there?
Yeah.
I'll put it in there for you. That's PNC Lads Weekly. That's the name of the playlist on Spotify. Yeah, go fucking like that shit, boys.
Yeah,
like that shit. Go share it.
Give us some suggestions and like segment ideas and things like that you want us to do. I mean, now we're done with event recaps, I guess, if you will. Mm. We've had Christmas, New Year, fucking Wildlands. So, yeah.
We're done with the debriefs, boys.
Yeah, give us some segment ideas. Maybe we go back to the oddly satisfying, dissatisfying stuff if you guys want that. But yeah, throw us some fucking ideas and we'll essentially sort of revamp the show a little bit. But yeah.
New year, new us, baby.
Yep.
New year, new us. Anyway, I hope you've had a fantastic 8 days of 2024. Well, it'll be 9 by the time you start listening.
I hope yours have been healthier than mine.
That's all we can say. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, we've been the PNC Lads.